Hi everyone, George Firican over here at AWS Summit with IBM.
And I'm Ted Tritchew. I'm a distinguished engineer and CTO of cloud consulting in Canada.
Well, it's a pleasure to have you on the show, Ted.
Oh, thank you for having me.
Well, the pleasure again is all mine. And so Ted, there's one thing that I noticed, and it's an unfortunate truth, that as companies grow older, they inherit this technical debt because of the legacy systems that they have, and for many reasons, they can't let go. It's hard to, it's very expensive. And yeah, in some instances, there's no other option for them to move to. But from what I understand, there are solutions out there.
There are solutions, yeah.
Yeah. Can you please tell us more about how maybe GenAI autonomous solutions would be able to help us with this?
So technical debt is a huge problem. We have clients who, you know, an example of technical debt would be even Java code with no unit tests. Mm-hmm. So it makes it very difficult to actually change the code because I'm not sure what, you know, if the changes will affect it.
No.
So with agentic solutions, so if you look at GenAI in four quadrants, you know, where the simplest is the bottom left quadrant, I'm solving simple problems, you know, ChatGPT or assistants, where you ask a question, you immediately get back an answer, and the answer is sometimes correct, partially correct.
Yeah.
But with agentics over in the right quadrant, I can solve more complex problems. I can have the agents plan how they're going to, you know, create unit tests. The agents can break up the work into smaller tasks. They can assign the right agent to do the right work. We can have one agent that writes a unit test, another agent that reviews the unit test, and they can talk back and forth for a while until the reviewer is happy with the results. And then I could either have a human in the loop, because with agents, they can have long-term memory. If the human's in the loop, the human can say, okay, well, you also missed this.
Right.
And then the agents will remember that answer. Or I can just have an optimizer agent that looks at the answer and says, I agree, or here are some things you can fix. If you make the third agent a different LLM, you get some really funny answers, like where, you know, Claude, for example, will complain to the OpenAI agents that they're doing it all wrong.
Right. So you do need that human touch still, but...
Still do. If you look at the logs of the agents talking to each other, like it's like real people. The coding agent never writes never writes unit tests.
Right.
So the reviewer agent says, well, where's the unit test? Just like a real reviewer.
Wow, that's incredible. So at one point, it really becomes indistinguishable as you're monitoring those conversations. You can't tell who is who.
And I always monitor the conversation because they do give a final answer, but they go back and forth and they give very compelling critiques.
Yeah.
They're self-improving, self-evolving. And we get some really good results. And I think over the next few months and into next year, we're going to see agents as part of my development squads.
Well, I mean, that's very helpful. And I think though, even with the help of all these agents with GenAI, there's still challenges in trying to modernize all these legacy applications into the cloud. Can you talk about some of the biggest challenges that you've seen?
So you kind of have to look at the mindset of the people who wrote the code. And if I wrote COBOL in the 80s, the mindset was I have 256 mega RAM. I'm going to split the app up into small procedures that all fit in memory, and then I'm going to tie them all together. So the business logic now is spread across hundreds of procedures. It's very difficult for the resources today who are maintaining or trying to modernize that code to figure out how does this thing hang together? It looks like spaghetti.
Right.
So first you have to demystify it. You know, tell me what all this code is doing in a business, like in a business manner. Like, and maybe it's, I usually have two prompts to my demystifier agents. Tell me what this code is doing and just summarize it in business terms so that a business user will understand. And my other prompt is convert this code or take this code, write requirements as user stories in a way that a junior developer can modernize it in the future.
Wow. And it's as easy as that. You don't need to write paragraphs worth of prompts in order to get the desired result.
As we've been playing with the agents, we found that if you try to prompt engineer mm-hmm. you reduce the effectiveness of the agent.
Very interesting.
Because the agents are actually creating their own prompts. So you tell them as simply as possible, here's what I want you to do. Create user stories.
This is great because it increases that usability and...
It more or less democratizes using GenAI.
Right.
Because anyone can just ask a simple question.
That's true.
I don't have to be a prompt engineer.
Yeah, you don't need to get a PhD in prompt engineering in order to get those desired results out of it.
But we remember the agents also can, you can give them skill or a set of tools. And if I need an agent to do arithmetic, I would give it a calculator mm-hmm. written in Python. Mm-hmm. If I need an agent to read documents, I just give it the ability to go open a document and read it. And so what you end up with is a set of agents that are very fine-grained. Each agent does a specific task and a set of skills that the agents can leverage. Mm-hmm. And the agentic framework will determine, well, which agent should I use? And which skills should the agent use to solve the problem that I've been given?
Right.
But very powerful.
What do you see the future holds on this? Do you think you will expand towards other languages as well? Maybe not as old, as ancient, as legacy?
So right now, our agents can do any language. Mm-hmm. So normally when I talk to the client, I say, well, what's your code base? So this morning I talked to a client and their code base was Power Builder. I said, and I went and got a bunch of Power Builder off the internet. I ran it through the Demystifier. And then I presented, here's how the Demystifier works with Power Builder. Well, I've done TL1, I've done Java, C#, DB, like pretty well anything that I've run through the agents, they can handle.
That's incredible. So, yeah. Again, the future looks bright, and thanks to IBM for helping.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks so much.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.